40-foot grandeur, Rod and Ita. Me being the decky, I'm going to carefully pull up his mainsail. Tiny chip we've got up.
Which strength is it? 13.
30 knots.
Get that head sail down for me. Anytime you're ready, mate, that's it, just go.
So that's how to get rid of the sail. It's not much fun, is it, compared to the old Narhval? I can sit here drinking my beer and I just pull this rope and the sail disappears. We're on Zulu. Ida's gone for a week holiday with a friend and I'm sailing back with Rod here, Captain Rod at the helm. And we've got 20 knots, kind of shit conditions, you know, it's not the best. We've got a reef in the main and fly in the little jib. And we're sitting on 6.5 knots.
7.2.
And we've had to put some glasses and things away, which makes me happy. So we're getting the boat moving. There's our reef there, and the red line's the second reef. The wine bottle was rolling around inside. M- makes me happy when there's salt water on Zulu, because he always fresh runs, he always cleans the boat down with fresh water. And we're sailing out here and he's going, we're getting salt water over the decks. That makes me happy. 21 knots. You're starting to come around that wind, Rod.
Yeah,
it's going to go down a little bit. Yeah. I say we
go for boat speed. It's got long, we're going
to drop it to my rock. That's what I reckon. So I've got a couple of friends coming out on Narhval the end of this week. Kane and Lauren. So the next video will be sailing Narhval. I might do a how-to video because those guys haven't sailed before and they're in the market for an old wooden boat. But it's good being on Zulu where there's stuff on the ground. Still hasn't moved these glass jars. But we got some, you know, things moving around here. It's good. It's a wild emotion on a cat. You get sort of battered around a bit. But we're going good. Captain's happy.
20 knots. What are you doing?
Have a sleep. From that spot, you can see the.
All the line and the jib. Check your
tail tiles. It's all good. Hatch cover, we got 25 knots now, running with the small jib. We got plenty of water through here.
Yeah. You just don't want to go in there too close.
I got some friends coming in a few days. I'm going to teach them how to sail. I thought I'd video it, so first thing we need to do is get some port and starboard markers up and some wool so they can see which way the wind's blowing, most important on a sailing boat, and I'll go through the do's and don'ts and I'll make a little video of it. I get to sail Narhval, teach a couple who are keen as in buying a wooden boat. These guys, I was going down to Tasmania with them to look at a wooden boat they wanted to buy. So I went down there and checked it out. The video's Tasmanian boat show or something. But Ken and Lars will be here and we're gonna do a wee bit of sailing. So that'll be fun. So yeah, I'm just getting the boat ship shape so I can show them the ropes. Had a nice sail back with Ron on Zulu. 20 plus knots, 25 knots. A little jib and a reef in the main. Rod was funny because he just fresh watered the boat. You know, it's all that shiny fiberglass, all white and shiny. And he's like, what's going on? I got the boat covered in salt water. It was coming right over his front windscreens that he just cleaned, so I thought that was good. And then he had to clean his sunglasses because there was salt spray. This isn't in the brochure. Bottles of red wine rolling around and bananas on the floor, so that made my day. Seeing Zulu going real well. We're doing over 7 knots to windward, pretty impressive. Anyway, back on the island after going over there and just getting some supplies. And now I'm back on Narhval fixing her up there. All right. Oh, comments, man. Erin and I are just friends. I still speak to her every day. Might come across like I miss her. Well, I do. I mean, sometimes, you know. But thanks for all the nice comments, and keep them coming. It's nice to know that people enjoy my movies. Next video, we're sailing Narhval. Wow. I was just saying yesterday, it'd be nice if I seen another wooden boat, you know, anchor near me. It'd be nice to see another wooden boat full stop. But this thing's out of control. Christ. Well, he's gone for the colour scheme black. I mean, I would love to do that to Narhval, but having a black boat in these conditions would just be nuts. I'll have a go at it.
Hey Simon, how are you, mate?
Hello, Rod.
Hey, coming for dinner?
We're gonna go watch the new series of Breaking Bad.
That's the way.
Oh. Why are we on a lee shore, Rod?
Mate, we just came here on Leakes Beach because apparently at 2 o'clock in the morning is about a 20 knot southwesterly coming, so it's better to put up with a bit of slop now. Because I reckon it.
Look what I've done.
2 in the morning. How did you get from Canada to here? Look at you.
I don't know.
Unbelievable.
Do you like my dinghy?
It's like held together with a piece of string.
Don't recommend this rope from Bunnings.
So what's the story with that dinghy, Simon? What's the go there?
I got that off my friend Drew.
Yeah.
And I can't use the canoe by myself.
Was Drew too embarrassed to use it, so he gave it to you?
Drew's too big and tough to use this little thingy, so he's giving it to me. So I row around in his bathtub now.
It's probably the best thing Drew ever did.
Yeah. You look ridiculous in it.
Yeah, he'd be too big for that.
Yeah. But nice.
But he'd be able to paddle it real quick. Look at that.
A bit of northerly happening. Yeah, a little bit
of slop.
10 knots maybe. Nicely.
Beautiful.
I like how you pick this spot.
Yeah, just so we don't run into the rocks.
Yeah, I thought that was a good idea.
Yeah, all right. Nice, nice.
Right spot. On.
See you back.
Bye. Goodbye. Woken up by dolphins this morning. Amazing. Catching the fish. He's clear. He's clear Narhval. Today, I'm working on the aft cabin. Yesterday, I got some Sikaflex down. If you can see here, on this whole cabin here, and then this deck. I secured all that deck there because it was all lifting up. And then I've done this whole cabin here, all the way down, then I ran out of Sikaflex. So I've just got that end piece to do. But the aft cabins need sanding. They're starting to look a bit rough. You can see there, needs doing.
So I'll spend the day sanding the aft cabin and digging out the old Sikaflex and re-Sikaflexing the. It's a mess, so let's see how things go. I won't video it all, but I'll video some of the stages I've done. That's what it looks like now. The bottom part's really bad. It's very hard to get off as well because it's Sikaflex. So I'm just using the scraper and a special scraping tool. It's coming up all right. You can see I've got my mainsail out. What's he been up to? I don't know, but I'd like to go for a sail today. It's just beautiful here. The water and the look at the light on the water. She's coming up all right. I don't have much more to do on Narhval. I mean, I do obviously, but the main things are my butterfly hatches, which haven't been done. All this is getting sanded back bare timber. I put my Sikaflex in the corner. This makes it hard to get in here. It's gonna take me a while, but I've also hit this gallows. So this is my gallows, and all the paint was black and falling off. So I'm just rubbing it back, get some primer on there, and I'll paint it green. Green.
Would you dream?